Hi again, this is Bill. Thank you for watching this third video of my free e-commerce training series. If you haven't watched video number one, video number two, please go down below in the YouTube description or in the Facebook post, or simply click on these pop-up buttons here and here, maybe above somewhere saying click for intro video or number two. So today we're going to discuss, as promised, specifically about the training, the tools, and in general, the preparation you need to do before even start sell your first product. So let's see quickly and answer some four basic questions on that topic: how to prepare, how to be prepared to sell something online successfully. So number one, of course, and you should start from here, it's where to sell your products. Okay, I believe in the beginning, if you're a new person, you don't have to invest money and time on building any shop, any store, drive traffic, all that very, let's say, techy stuff. Okay, so let's see the easy way. These are the three selling platforms I recommend: eBay, of course, Amazon, and the biggest search engine, Google. You can sell them, let's say, through Bonanza. Okay, I will put here Bonanza. And I highly advise, specifically for you that are newbies, that are new people involved with e-commerce, invest all your time, be educated on how these selling platforms work on feedback, on customers, on sellers, on cases, on returns, everything. These three should be, let's say, your MBA. Okay. Number two. Of course, the first question that most people have when they begin with e-commerce: what to sell, how to source items. Okay. How to source items. Okay. Since some of you in the beginning may have no investment at all, they want first to sell and then to buy low for their customers, the drop shipping product sourcing model. It's very easy to do, so I advise to check a couple things. First, open in your browser a local an online store like Walmart, like Amazon, like Kmart, like Costco. See what they sell in the front page, and of course, the seasons. So for example, the questions on that answer should be trends. And I will put here, for example, some big e-commerce seasons, like, for example, garden stuff. I've made tens of thousands in pounds and dollars in garden stuff. The garden season, more or less, it starts from March, let's say, mid-September, late August. So garden, let's say here, what else? Halloween, and of course, Christmas. Okay. These are some trends. Number two, check what other sellers have sold. So I will put here sold listings. Go on eBay or on Amazon, or go on eBay and type, for example, here now it's early September. Type, for example, patio sets. See what type of patio garden sets, dining sets were sold. Or click, for example, Halloween. Halloween's in a few weeks, and see what Halloween similar products, decorations, inflatables, whatever, have been sold, so you can take some ideas. And here, and third, let's say popular, I will put here as it is, popular retailers. And I will type here Walmart, Costco, etc. Check their websites, what they promote in their first page. These are the products also you should focus to sell. Number three, I believe you can see my screen now, so let me lower it a bit. Okay, should be fine. And very crucial, specifically if you are international like me, it's to get paid, and of course, pay for your inventory, for your products, to your customers. What I suggest here, and of course, what will happen if you sell on Google and eBay, you need to have a PayPal account, verified and prepared. I highly suggest have also some funds up there, not with zero balance, because PayPal has a very strict policy for new sellers. If they have, let's say, low capital, low approved balance, low amount in dollars, in pounds, whatever you're going to sell. So it's very, it's wise in the beginning to have some money out there, not the thousands, let's say a couple hundred bucks or euros or pounds, whatever you're going to sell. Then, if you sell on Amazon, you'll have, let's say, put bank. Amazon will pay you every 2 weeks. Okay, bank. And also in the description below, you could find and read some information about PayPal and Amazon. So click on that information below. It's for your own reference. Bank. And let's say about getting paid, about pay to your suppliers, for your customers, are the cards. I highly suggest in the beginning, no matter where you're located, secure your online payments with online debit, MasterCards, online accounts. Like, I will put here online account. For example, a very popular one, it's Payoneer. Okay, you can also connect Payoneer with your Amazon account and accept the payments from Amazon directly in the currency, in dollars or in pounds or in euros, wherever you sell your products. And number four, it's of course how to create good listings and be in front of your competition. So how to create awesome, I like this word, awesome listings. Okay. You need the tools. This is where the tools take place, and we'll also do one course specifically about tools and what tools I suggest and I have tested, me and my students, for your own personal e-commerce business. So I will put here listing tools. That means for eBay, for Amazon, or for Bonanza, okay. And number three, of course, it's the tracking. How to track your sourced URLs for stock availability, for price changes. So I'll put it tracking and management. And that will be in your future, in your first 2 weeks, your main focus and where your most hours will be put in. How to find products, list them, and track them. And believe me, you need not only the softwares, but you may need, after a few months, a couple, let's say years, the manpower to do that. One man only cannot handle an e-commerce business selling on eBay UK, on eBay.com, on Google, on Amazon US, on Amazon UK, maybe on another platform. That's a lot of man hours for only one person to handle. So then you should also focus on outsourcing and ask for assistance, for example, like Upwork. So more or less, these are the today's topics. Please write them down, make a print screen. Remember to comment below. If you like the video, you can like it, share it, whatever you want to do. But I would love your comments below, and also what you want from me to hear the next coming days and weeks from my free e-commerce training series. Because I'm not willing to just be a teacher and open a book and just give you some bullet points. But I would like to hear your suggestions, your, let's say, what obstacles you face in your e-commerce business, or whatever you want to hear from me. So thank you for watching. See you in my next video of my free e-commerce training series, and we'll discuss about sourcing tools and some extra ideas that will help you in your beginning. Take care.